So we did a video regarding the axis designation for a standard two-path control Swiss-style machine with a pose gang slide. Now we're gonna do a video here showing the difference between a two-path and a three-path control. The tooling layout almost looks identical. As a matter of fact, I used the same rudimentary drawing, just changed the axis designations around a little bit because of the fact that there's more functionality with a three-path control. So this is an opposed split slide gang style Swiss. So split slide, basically what it does is separates this slide from this slide. With an opposed gang slide machine, just standard opposed two path, these two slides are always connected. So they have to move together wherever they go. What happens with a split slide is we separate these two. So now this and this are independent from each other. Now we have X1 movement here, X3 movement here, Y1 movement here, and Y3 movement here. So these can move like this, they can move in and out like this, and this Z3 axis really makes a huge difference, and that has its own axis coming out this way, 60 millimeters of stroke. And this machine particularly that we're talking about would be our BW series. This could be either a 129, 209, or 329Z. So we have independent X, independent Y, and a third Z axis that allows us to move that rear gang slide in and out. A lot of capability adding that third Z axis. Now we can drill and turn simultaneously. We can actually pinch turn, so I can be roughing and finishing simultaneously while I'm feeding out my Z1. I can be pinch milling, so I can have a milling spindle on this slide, a milling spindle on this slide, and I can actually move pinch mill this way or same direction from top to bottom, bottom to top. So on a three-path machine, we have NC1, which would be X1 front gang slide, Y1 front gang slide, and Z1 is your main spindle. On path 2, NC2, we're gonna have X2, Y2, Z2, just like the two-path control. This is not gonna change whatsoever. It looks exactly the same. NC3 is what we're adding on top of this. Now that's gonna be X3, Y3, and Z3. That's gonna be dedicated to this rear gang slide. You're gonna have X3, Y3, and Z3 is gonna move this gang slide, this rear gang slide, completely independent to the front. We could actually be doing an internal thread with Z3 and an external thread with Z1, different pitches simultaneously. So you can really slash cycle times with a three-path control because you can double up on your operations and have three tools in the cut at the same time. So just to reiterate, NC1 is XYZ1, front gang slide and main spindle. NC2, subspindle and subspindle gang slides. And NC3 is gonna be XYZ3 rear gang slide. That would be how the axis designation works on a three-path control compared to a two-path control.